Hi everyone. Today in this video, let us discuss 8 symptoms of hyperkalemia. Since potassium plays an important role, their level should be properly maintained. When these potassium levels are in between 3.5 to 5 millimoles per liter, then it is considered as normal levels of potassium. Here potassium is measured within the serum, so these are the serum potassium levels. But when these potassium levels are reduced less than 3.5 millimoles per liter, then it is considered as hypokalemia, the lower levels of potassium, which is again fatal to the patients. So potassium should be properly maintained within this 3.5 to 5 millimoles per liter for normal functionality of many of the organs. But when these potassium levels are slightly elevated from 5 to 5.5 millimoles per liter, then it can be considered as border high potassium levels. And further, when they are elevated from 5.5 to 6.5 millimoles per liter, we can observe the symptoms of hyperkalemia. So when the potassium levels are above 5.5, it can be considered as hyperkalemia. These levels can be further increased greater than 6.5 millimoles per liter. Then we can observe the severe symptoms of hyperkalemia, which can affect the different organs. So high potassium levels may be observed because of different reasons. And when they are above 5.5 millimoles per liter, it can be considered as hyperkalemia. But when these potassium levels are above 6.5 millimoles per liter, we can observe severe symptoms of hyperkalemia, which mainly affect the two organs. One is the heart and second one is the muscle. So it is very essential to know the symptoms of hyperkalemia, and we should know the different symptoms that are connected with elevated levels of potassium. So now if we see the symptoms associated with hyperkalemia, we can remember these symptoms by using a small mnemonic. They can be split into two parts. The first one is the pace and second one is the warn. So hyperkalemia can produce a pace warn, where the symptoms pace are associated with cardiac system. We can observe racing heartbeats. So these symptoms can be remembered with simple mnemonic pace, where P indicates palpitations, A indicates arrhythmias, C chest pain, and E ECG changes. So these are the first group of symptoms associated with hyperkalemia, which are completely related with cardiac system. And second group of symptoms can be remembered with simple mnemonic warn, because they are going to warn the elevated levels of potassium. And these symptoms are associated with muscle weakness, which can be remembered with this mnemonic warn. Here the W indicates the weakness of muscle, A abdominal pain, R respiratory failure, and N nausea and vomiting. So these are the 8 symptoms that can be produced by hyperkalemia, which can be remembered as pace warn. Now let us focus on these symptoms and let us discuss one by one. The first one is the palpitations. Potassium is very important for cardiac functionality. Particularly, it is important for repolarization phase within the cardiac action potential. This repolarization starts from phase 3 to phase 4. So by elevated levels of potassium, we can observe the disturbance in the action potential, resulting in the increased heart rate, leading to fast heartbeats. People can observe some awareness of heartbeat, some fluttering of heart can be observed, and racing heartbeats can be observed. So all these symptoms are collectively called as palpitations, which can be observed with elevated levels of potassium. Second one, arrhythmias. Just we have discussed that cardiac functionality is highly affected by potassium. Then what happens with low levels of potassium? On the cardiac membrane, sodium potassium ATPase pump is present, which is controlling the levels of sodium within the cardiac membrane. This is an exchange pump which allows the potassium inside and sodium outside. Now in the people with low potassium levels, few ions of potassium can enter for exchange of few ions of sodium. So most of the sodium is retained within the cardiac membrane because of low levels of potassium. This results in elevated levels of sodium within the cardiac membrane. As the sodium levels are increased, it can increase the excitability of cardiac membrane. Even it can increase the automaticity by reducing the threshold potential. So in the people with low potassium, we can observe increased cardiac excitability and automaticity. The reverse can be observed with high potassium levels. When the potassium levels are excessively elevated, potassium can more enter into the cardiac membrane for exchange of more amount of the sodium. So this results in the decreased levels of sodium within the cardiac membrane. This results in the decreased cardiac conduction as well as decreased automaticity, and even it reduces the action potential generation. Because of this, cardiac arrhythmias can be observed. Some abnormal rhythm can be observed with higher levels of potassium. In such people, we can observe some irregular heartbeats, which is another symptom of elevated levels of potassium. Third one is the chest pain. High potassium levels can produce some chest pain, tightness in the chest, dizziness, lightheadedness, and some shortness of breath can be produced. Fourth one, ECG changes. This is again important, where development of hyperkalemia can be immediately checked by any changes in the ECG. In the people with hyperkalemia, we can observe tall and peaked T wave. This is because higher levels of potassium can affect phase 4 of repolarization. So we can observe elevated T wave in presence of hyperkalemia. Similarly, it may also result in the loss of P wave, sometimes a small P wave or even absent of P wave can be observed. Similarly, we can also observe prolonged PR interval and widening of QRS complex. Any of these changes in the ECG may indicate development of hyperkalemia. Fifth one, weakness of muscle. High potassium levels can produce some muscle weakness, and it can increase the muscle twitching, which may result in muscle cramps, fatigue, even some numbness in the muscle. All these can be observed with elevated levels of potassium. Sixth one, abdominal pain. Elevated potassium levels can affect the functionality of the stomach as well as the intestine. So it can produce some abdominal pain and abdominal discomfort. Even they can produce some diarrhea or constipation. So any severe abdominal discomfort along with chest pain, palpitations, arrhythmias, and muscle weakness may indicate development of hyperkalemia. Seventh one, respiratory failure. Just we have seen that high potassium can affect muscle weakness. So respiratory muscles can be affected, resulting in respiratory failure, leading to shortness of breath and difficulty breathing. Even high potassium levels can also produce renal failure because of high potassium load for excretion. So here the R letter can be remembered as a respiratory failure as well as renal failure with chronic elevation of potassium levels. Eighth one, nausea and vomiting. This is another symptom of high potassium. Because of elevated levels of potassium, it can affect the stomach as well as intestine. Even it can induce the reflex response, resulting in nausea and vomiting. This is the first sign that can be observed with higher levels of potassium when they are crossing 5.5 millimoles per liter. But when they cross 6.5 millimoles per liter, we can observe severe symptoms like chest pain, palpitations, arrhythmias, and ECG changes. Even it can produce some severe muscle weakness and difficulty in breathing. All these symptoms are collectively related with hyperkalemia. So that's all about the 8 important symptoms of hyperkalemia. Hope this video is useful to you. If you really like this video, please subscribe to our channel, share this video with your friends, post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.